killed. It's a hot button issue we've been reporting about now for a couple of weeks. A group has arrived in Albuquerque in hopes of reforming sex offender laws. Action 7 News reporter Amber Lee tells us why these folks think the sex offender registry needs to be changed.
Well, Royal, more than 100 people have registered for the 4th annual Reform Sex Offenders Law National Conference being held right here in Albuquerque. Now, I spoke to a convicted sex offender who thinks changes need to be made because he says not every offender deserves a life sentence on the registry.
Public registries, from our perspective, are not appropriate. They're ineffective. They're causing people to get murdered.
John Cordero knows all too well what it's like to be labeled as a sex offender.
Are you a registered sex offender?
I sure am.
He says he was convicted of molesting a child, but John says he got his life back on track after he turned himself in to get help for his sexual behavior. He now helps reform sex offenders coming out of prison to transition back into the community. This weekend, he's part of a group holding a conference fighting to reform sex offender laws.
Every 90 days, I had to go down, fingerprints, photograph, in the lobby of the sheriff's department. Very humbling, considering I was working in that community to help other sex offenders not commit new crimes.
The group believes that once sex offenders serve their time and probation, they shouldn't have to be on the registry.
They have a right to go on with their lives, rebuild their lives, and become a productive member of society.
But Stacy Sandoval, a mother of a sex crime victim, doesn't agree.
They should be held accountable for the rest of their lives as well, without just a slap on the wrist.
A controversial topic that has a lot of people on edge, but the conference hopes it will get people talking and also change the way they think. APD officers are patrolling outside of the conference, which runs through Sunday.
Thanks, Amber. Earlier this week, APD held a town hall meeting to ease the community's concerns about this event. They also told citizens they could call the chief's office, but police say they have not received any phone calls so far.